Jesus.
Your man Nico Star.
And it's Long Arm Low.
We're here for another episode of Fours and Doors.
You know.
Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we got SD Stiletto Drivers in the building. In here to tell us what's going on with them. Come on, ladies, make some noise. Do something.
We're trying to be
quiet.
Hey,
we live now.
Right now.
All right, so let's do some intros as usual. Okay.
All right. Inferno.
Girl, you better get up on that mic, girl.
I'm doing it.
Get on that mic.
That mic don't want it. I'll be Inferno, Vice President for Stiletto Drivers.
I'm BD. I'm the road captain for Stiletto Drivers. She was quiet. Oh, I'm Miss Shay, the PRO for Stiletto Drivers.
All right.
Yeah. Okay.
All girls.
All women.
All women.
I'm about to say I'm the wrong one.
I'm sorry. All women.
All grown.
All grown.
Exactly.
Grown ass woman.
Grown. Mm-hmm.
That's what's up. I got
you. Go in the curse for Shay.
Better tell it like no.
Like Miss Mabel, they own me. All right, we'll get to it. So, like, when did y'all start? Like, when did y'all come out?
2011.
Huge.
2011.
Veteran.
So, Honey's dream was to have a club. So, Honey Bee is the CEO founder who's not here. But Honey Bee's vision was as a single, or as a only child, to have sisters. So, it's kind of weird to have all women in one place and everybody on the same accord. So her vision, and we are a part of her vision. So we just enjoy more of a sisterhood, hanging around each other, fooling with our cars to, you know, we need a mechanic now. Ferno needs a mechanic. Because my nails can't get dirty. Ferno, I have a vision. I need somebody else to make it work. But hypothetically, this was Honey's baby, and it is still her baby. We're just parts of it.
Parts of the machine.
Parts of the machine.
See, I like how you come on. You represent your founder so well. Some of y'all need to take notes. Y'all, let me see where she just came up with. Honey's dream. The vision. You know what I mean? That's what you want. That's like when Michael Jackson's kids talk about it. Daddy wanted to be great. There was a move. What was everything? Man. So,
that's reality. We're sisterhood.
Your sister.
That's what we are.
So why not a social club? Why? What made y'all like want to do the car thing? Like, there's not too many females. It's like
all female.
Into the car thing. All female. You mean?
Why do we do a social club?
Yeah, like
reality is everybody may not have a car, but they want to be a part of a group.
Right.
And you cannot discriminate when people want to be a part of something. So you got to find a way to put everybody together, and yes, they'll be on the same page.
I thought you were supposed to discriminate, like,
no, we're
against
not.
Certain
no, we're
stuff.
Not. No,
okay,
we're
so what
a
was...
man cannot join our club unless you can walk some sense.
You discriminating now.
You know, but I'm just saying, hypothetically, like, if everybody may not be in a place where they can have a car.
Right.
So because you have a vision that you want to hang around us, or you want to be getting a car, a social club is just that. You're just a part of it. You don't have to have a vehicle to be a part of anything. Mm-hmm. You just don't. Your mind does not have to say, oh, I don't have a car, but I can't hang around y'all. No, you find a way to help others get to where you are without putting them down. And that's the vision, because a social club member can get a car. It may not be the best car. It may not be the car you like, but at the end of the day, a car is a car. And with the discrimination that we have against each other with cars is a problem that we have right now. I don't care if you drive a Pinto. Let that Pinto be the best Pinto you have.
I'm with that.
I mean, that's reality.
So they can't wear Stiletto, though.
Oh, we have.
That's a mandatory thing. Mandatory. If you can't walk in a 6-inch heel, don't even put in that out.
So do y'all like test them out first? Like,
see how they walk in a Stiletto?
No, we're not going to test you out, because a part of the application, it states what we are. The beginning of it says Stiletto. Stiletto means heel. Stiletto means that's understanding. So you don't have to reiterate what a heel is.
Do y'all supply the heel? They got to get their own.
No. What?
I mean, I'm just saying. Y'all got a set. Like, these are the heels that we wear.
Everybody?
I'm like, yeah.
Can you help us?
I can't, bro.
No. You say yes. So, see, when you say yes, you can't take it back.
Nah.
Okay.
Y'all ain't call no 50, so take backs.
What?
What?
They don't know.
That was like alien level.
I'm saying. You didn't call it take backs. But
okay.
That's what
they okay. Okay. Take back. No, we're going to get that back. We got to come back with something.
We're going to go out and swap me. I can find something. Long arm low here. Beast them for those. No problem. So, but y'all been one of the vet clubs. Like, how many clubs was out 2011 when you came out? Like, how many were there?
I can't remember.
If you had to take a guesstimate, what would you say?
I don't know. Fern will be turned up majority of the time. God. I'm keeping it real. I just don't know. I mean, Kings and Queens, Hustle Heavy. I don't know. Can I go back on Facebook and look at some pictures from there?
Yeah, wow. So you got to look at the names. I can't think of them off top. That's a long time.
Can my age help me? Because I need, can I find a lifeline?
She needs a lifeline.
Like,
whoa. Who one you want to use? Who one you want to use? What call in. Somebody help a friend out tonight.
All right, so was SD your first club, though? Like, you never been
to
West? First and only. Everybody?
First and only.
How long y'all been there? Well, I know you've been there since.
I'm 4, 5, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5.
She said she went 4, 5.
I'm still be going on like my third year, I believe, because I've been with SD, and I haven't turned back since. Well, this young grasshopper here. September will make 2 years for me.
Okay, so everybody's been in the dirt for a minute, basically. You know what I mean? Or what I would call in the dirt. You know what I mean? You've been through the struggle. You ain't one of the new people that just came in and while you was already popping and you had to build it up from the ground up.
No.
I'm glad you elaborated on that because I was about to say, I don't play in dirt.
Like, I wasn't in the dirt either.
Well, rest up. You don't get your nails dirty. You know, we got that.
How
Well, okay. Skip that. Well, everybody say, well, y'all older club, so y'all been around. So everybody say, it's always this big thing going around now about how the CC used to be compared to how it is right now. So y'all been an older club, especially Inferno being 2011. My bad, and then the bang on the table on my own stuff. But you know, what do you see the difference between now and then? Because they act like it's a totally different world.
Yeah.
Reality is, I don't see a difference.
Because Inferno was jacked up anyway.
No, I'm not saying like that, but it's like. As a founder, you set the foundation for your club. You allow them to do whatever it is. So whatever your vision is for your club, you need to continue that. And when you put people in roles, presidents, vice presidents, sergeant arms, they need to follow that accordingly. So if you just go out here and say, oh, you know what? You look like you can be a good member of my club and pick up anybody in the corner, you're going to get anybody in the corner in your club. That's why we had a prospect period. So you can really find out this is what you want. Numbers are not always what you need.
Absolutely.
You don't always need numbers. You don't need 40 of us to show anything. We can take our 14 and be happy. It's 14, 15.
Y'all tripping. Okay. It's 15.
It's 15. I was off a number.
Thank y'all.
I was about to Google
Wait,
that.
Let us check the group meeting.
Exactly where I was going. Let me go to group meeting.
I almost went there, but I was like,
hey, right by my head. You don't need numbers. And when you have a generation that thinks that racing and trying to kill each other on these streets. No, you don't need to kill each other. You really don't. Your car can look nice. You just enjoy what you enjoy. And that's just reality of it. So what was done 10 years ago, 5 years ago, the thing is people want to pull guns. People want to be jealous. Go get a job. Mm. Get up and get what you want instead of being jealous of the next person. You have on 22s, I have on 24s, you have on 16s. It doesn't matter. That's my car. That's what I want. And that's what people have to do, whatever you want to your car, and stop the hating. Stop getting so jealous and upset when others are doing something else. So our president has walked in.
Hello.
Let her come on in.
Was
he here? Okay, I'm standing
over here with
you. Oh, okay. So
I was
here. That's just reality of it for me. So it's not like there's a whole lot of a difference. It's just different people, and the foundations that we need to set need to stay there. Right. Instead of a new club pops up, you go from club to club, and then we have this big old mess. But you got to realize where the mess starts at. So you can't, if you leave one club and go to another, the mess still going to be there because you have to evaluate yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just reality for me.
So you think it's an age thing?
Age has nothing to do with it. You can have a mature 25-year-old and a reckless 40.
That's true.
That's just reality. Yeah, so it doesn't, I don't think age has anything to do with it. I just think that your mentality, where you see yourself, I don't want to be burying anybody because I want to be up here on 210 racing.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't control my car. You have to know your car. So if you're not racing and your car's not for racing, V6, V8, it doesn't matter. They're cars, they're going to move. So I'm not going to kill myself and try to show off. No, my life is more important than that. So you go ahead. Just make sure you get that red light when it comes and everything is good. I mean, that's just reality for me.
And plus, I love my car.
I love my car. Forget that.
So it was like more of the stunt scene than more of the racing.
Yeah. So you got, it's a give and take, but it starts with the leaders.
Right. So is that like a necessity, you would think? I would think like if you're in a car club, the thing is to have a nice car. But if you don't, like, why are you here?
Is that a requirement?
Like, for y'all, do y'all have a requirement? Like, is there mods or something that you have to do? Or is it just...
We say you have to have 3 mods done to your car eventually, but... Honestly, if you're in a car club, some car clubs, and especially older ones, way before us, way before any of us started, was about car enthusiasm. It wasn't necessarily you had to have the best car. It was that you had to have the enthusiasm for a car and you kept your car good.
Mm-hmm.
We have some girls whose cars may not be the best out here. They may not be stunting out here. It's people out here that you want your car to stunt. So that's what it's about. But for us, it's more about than just your car stunting. It's about you have a love for your car. You have a love for what you do. You have a love for your community. So if you have that, then it's okay to be in a club. Now, if you're in a club that's about show cars and that's what your club is about, then yes, your car needs to be stunting. It needs to be the best out there on the street. It will at least be the best to your club. But I'm never going to turn someone away that's a car lover, because their car isn't the best. But at the same time, if your car isn't the best, you have to aspire to bring it up to look like something. So that's, I mean, when we first started this, I was driving a Charger, and then life had to change, and I had a minivan. My minivan may not have been the best to everybody. People was like, oh, she in a club with a minivan. But my minivan was good. And I am one that will race. And I race people in my minivan and smoke them in my minivan. So it is what it is.
Lord. Okay. So y'all heard the dudes right there. Dream Girl says she got the caravan outside. Line it up. She will bust that ass.
She don't have right now.
Yeah, I'm in my Camaro now.
Okay.
You gotta get in the minivan.
I'm
in beauty
up
right now. You need to take all colors, but it is what it is.
Park that. You get it anyway. Catch you on soccer mom day. You still get fucked up. All right. Yeah, wow.
So my question, Ferno said earlier that sometimes things happen and the club member might not have cars, but this is an auto club, though. And that's the main rule that you have to have as a car.
We are not just the auto club.
Okay. Can you explain a
little more? We are Stiletto Drivers. We have Stiletto Drivers, which are part of the auto club. But we also have Stiletto Drivers that have a social club. We've had this since day one. We have members who are riders. They're our riders. They ride with us. They do everything that's required. They just may not have wheels. But they got heels, so as long as they rocking their stiletto.
They got to be so volatile to get us some heels.
What? Oh, yeah. I said, we won't go down and swap me.
Your feet is the most important part of your body because it has to handle all your weight. Yes, I am. I just came from work, so no, I have my flats on, but I can go out to the car and get you 3 pairs of heels right now.
So you already got it.
Yes.
Somebody got 5, man. Somebody got 5 because they had to put their heels.
Only 3 people can fit my heels in this room. Mm. So
is that a 5? You step out without stilettos?
If you are in stiletto drivers and you come out in the public and you do not have your stilettos. Now, like I said, I have mine in the car and I can bring them in. But if we are out and you have none nowhere to be found, yes, you will be fine.
Do you got to drive with them, or it's just only when you get out?
If you look at our founder's car, if you look at Honey's car,
see Honey car.
So you've seen the hole in her.
I've not seen her floorboard.
She has a hole in her floorboard from her stiletto.
Damn,
that probably helps the little. you got to rest your foot on the nothingness, so you just holding it right there with the bottom. That's sweet. Not for me, I'm saying. But that's cool. I like that.
So, do y'all need get any havoc from males now that you know? Because you know, y'all all girls.
We have Mr. Stiletto. Women. Well, it seemed like every year we get a Mr. Stiletto. We got somebody. They say they are the honorary male stiletto driver. So they the only male that can be associated with the club.
Are they heterosexual?
They are heterosexual.
Yeah. Would y'all take like a gay dude if he wanted to get down with y'all? Like,
if he comes and he's dressed as a she and he's doing, if he's shim And not him.
What if he looked like Rick Ross with a dress on?
he's going to be in the back of the picture. You know, when we all like this, he's going to be like this. He can put his feet up.
Oh my gosh.
He meets the requirement of heels in the back.
But I'm serious though. Like, y'all would
How can we be like, oh, you can't be a part, but he identifies himself as a woman?
Because y'all are women. Y'all are women.
But he identifies.
Real women.
Who am I?
I identify myself as a millionaire, but I'm not, though.
You're bringing it into existence.
Damn straight.
I identify myself as a dream girl, but I mean, I might not be your dream girl, but I'm somebody's damn dream girl, so we're going to speak into existence.
I could be somebody fired.
Oh, shit.
Exactly.
That's one of my questions. They said, why is Inferno always turned up?
It's called Patron Margarita.
I didn't have any today.
Oh, no, yeah. Baby. No. What you doing?
I didn't have any today.
Man. I had some prosciutto for you, so this is good. Prosecco.
Oh, man. Then we go to Fridays after this. To start my birthday off with my drink? No.
It is Inferno's birthday. People didn't know. Happy birthday to Inferno.
It's coming. It's coming.
It's tomorrow.
It's
Lord.
She turned a big 23.
Hello.
With the bazillion.
Oh, yeah. I don't know what that means, but
my hair. That's my hair when it grows. Oh, okay. Yeah, it grows real long.
Cordy said pop cups, but.
Okay. Come get it, Cordy.
I got to think, like, we got, like, females in the CC now, right? Like, do y'all feel like there's a difference between the veteran females that started like ourselves and the ones that kind of come out now?
I will say this. Being that we've been in here for 7 years, I've seen a lot of messiness, a lot of pettiness, and it's some everywhere. I mean, even we might have some in our group, but we try to make sure that our girls keep themselves at a standard above. Not saying we're better than anybody else, but they will tell you, I'm always on them. Don't post your business on social media. Don't post our business on social media. What goes on in our house stays in our house. So whatever we got going on, the CCC don't need to know.
I know it's a lot going on with all females. I just know it's a lot going on.
But here's the thing. Females forget. They want to fight. And this is what I'm saying in the CCC. You want to fight somebody over this dude that's in this club and this dude. But guess what? You trying to fight over him. He not claiming you, boo-boo. When he over here with her, he like, man, she pressed. See this message. See how she pressing me out. See these news she sending me. Well, you know what? If you presented yourself like a lady, first of all, if your coochie ain't worth nothing but an inbox picture, then that's what you gonna get. An inbox with somebody's
inbox picture.
I don't have no inbox coochie, so you won't see mine on nobody's inbox. You want to see it? You gonna have to come see it and do that. But we're not saying that, and we tell our girls, you know, when these girls out here and they petty, they want to beef. First of all, you beef with one stiletto driver, you beefing with, we can all be friends with you, but at the same time, this your friend, but you beef with her, we gonna jump your ass. And it's not about jumping you as far as fighting you. We not gonna let you get to her and make her look bad in front of everybody. Because when you out there fussing and fighting and being this petty little CCC girl, that's all you're gonna be known for. Like, what is your community? What is your community outreach? What are you known for? You known for smoking a blunt, having a shot? Guess what? I make dream juice all day. I'll give it to your drunk ass. But at the end of the day, the proceeds that was made from that dream juice by you looking stupid out here about to fight somebody, Stiletto Drivers has done donated that money to some little girl who doesn't have a home because her mother was out here fighting somebody and now she's homeless. You got to be above that. We too old for that. And if you know, 25 and under, and that's all you know, then maybe you need to get with somebody that's over 25 so they can help lead you the way. If we don't lead each other, you know what I'm saying? If we don't teach them, it's each one teach one. If we not teaching them, then how they gonna learn?
So do y'all recruit or do y'all just let them come y'all way? Like, you seem like you got it at the present, you got your head on straight. So maybe you should take on some of these youngest, like you said, 25 or younger, and show them the right way.
When they come to us, if they have sense, they will be kept. Anybody in this room, you haven't interacted with me much, but anybody in this room will tell you, you gotta have a real level head to be in a club with Dream Girl.
I feel you.
Yes, Lord. What do you do?
because I have absolutely no filter, and it's not from a bad place. It's from a place of love. So,
hi.
I will absolutely tell you from love that.
That's not how
we're going. You want to lie for you? Come on, move over, baby. I will always tell you from a place of love, you wrong. It is what it is. I'm going to tell you you wrong. You ain't got to like it. You ain't got to love it, but you're still wrong. You ain't got to like what I say. But you're going to be wrong. And come on, challenge me, because I'm going to challenge you right back. And if you can't deal with it, the door is open.
What'd you say? In that order.
They'll tell you, like, and Inferno isn't that far behind me. Don't get it twisted. Don't get
Look
it twisted.
Look at her face. She can't even take herself seriously.
Because she will tell somebody, hey, fine.
I will not do it like, no.
What?
Look, see?
Damn.
No.
In front of like the parent that you wanted to call this.
My mom. So it's just like, you get out the car, you know your responsibilities. We don't have to go back. You have your bylaws, your bad vibe. So I just be like, oh, okay, that's how you feel. I like it. Get me. Get me. That's it. Just check your inbox.
That was like first time we went out to, what was it, bike night. I had on some tennis shoes. She said, your shoes look nice. I said, oh, thank you.
Nicely got an inbox.
Your shoes look nice. Thinking this means something. Let me go in that car real quick.
You know you're fucked up, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
How do y'all maintain the chemistry? Because I know just, like, we got a social club. And I love all of them to death. I know y'all watching. But they go at it sometimes, like cats and dogs. Like, how do y'all maintain the bond with just, like, I know it's hard to have a bunch of ladies. Like, it's always, you know what I mean? I think each one of you, no disrespect with it, but women are, you know what I'm saying? Like, y'all got your own ego. And it's like, y'all just bounce off each other. To the fullest. How does this hold it together? And for men, 11 years, like, that's a long time.
Look, how do you hold it together?
Jesus.
I'm going to come up for you to pray. Pray.
No.
What you need to do.
Like, don't get me wrong. Like, we have all personalities. We all females. We have our times when I just be like, I can't stand this lady right here. But we know that the love is stronger. So, if we have an issue, we talk through our problems and move on.
We shed a lot of tears.
Jesus.
We fight today, and 10 minutes is over with, and it's like, okay, what we about to do? Because we can't hold on to it. And that's the problem. You can't hold. So if I deal with the issue, we're going to deal with it, and we're going to keep on moving. Mm-hmm. Holding on to the issue just keeps more issues. So deal with whatever it is, and then be like, okay. Because believe me, it's not peaches and creams, but we make it peaches and cream. Believe it.
You gotta keep the boxing gloves in the trunk sometimes.
They can't bring no boxing gloves out. That's a fine and a suspension.
See, we just going down.
We gonna get in the room. We ain't none of y'all here to look. We gonna yell at each other. Be like, don't give a fuck with you. Cry. Go ahead.
Exactly.
Go ahead. You done? All right. So now what's next?
No, I can hear. Look at Dream Girl. You need to lap dance now.
Exactly. You want me to put it on you?
It's lap dance time. That's what we're talking about.
Yeah.
Come on. We give out lap dances and everything in the club. Only in the club now. Only exactly. In the club. Yeah. Club get lap dance.
Don said y'all that's the only group of females with no drama.
That's a damn
thanks,
lie.
Thanks,
Don. No, we know how to be adult about our issues.
It's the letter of the only all-girl auto club. It's the only one that I know.
Actually, there has been 4 pop-ups of all. It's one in Richmond. They started 2 years ago. They started out with, I think they came out with 10 people the last time I looked. And they were the only one in Virginia. No, boo-boo, I'm in Virginia, babe. Sorry. But we welcome you. Now, last time I looked, I think they had 4 out of 10. There's one in Baltimore. Chinky is old. Well, they got a tranny now. I think, but so they're still long. They're still long. I have to think about it, but I think Disturbance is all female, minus, yeah, and there's one other one. There's one that came out last year at the end of the summer down Waldorf. But I don't know if they're still out because I haven't seen them post since like the first 3 weeks of the.
Well, I guess
out.
That like kills the next question was like, do y'all like interact with each other?
Well, we interact with anyone who wants to play. So
We are big girls.
Yes, we always got our big girl panties on. You can, you know, we do what we do.
We like the pretty panties, not the big
things. Yeah.
Oh, excuse me, big girl panties are pretty.
Are the pretty
Wednesday, my old panties from 4 years ago. We said the new models.
So if y'all do pick up a shim, smell, whatever you want to call it, would y'all consider yourself still a...
Or female. He identifies as a woman.
But he don't.
He not real good. First and the legs were good. And the legs
first
are
of all, no. First of all, we not going inspecting somebody. Saying, let me see shit. Open legs up.
Would you tell somebody, though, like, if it was a dude from another club and shout out, you seen him talk, would you be like, hey,
No. Go ahead.
You for real? You riding for your bristles.
Go ahead.
Hey, go.
You got to stand up like this. Look at him.
That's cold though, man. I feel like y'all would have to tell somebody, because that's how people end up getting killed behind stuff like that.
You gotta look at it like this.
If everybody went out here being whores trying to fuck everything that's walking,
yeah,
then it wouldn't be, it's not my business. That's like saying that's like saying if one of my girls are hoes, that's her business. If she got an STD, again, that's her business. I'm not gonna be like, got the souls.
I mean, but that's different saying, he got a dick. Like, come on.
I will be honest, and I would not come at you that way. There has been situations with former members, not current members, but former members that I knew that was little, and they tried to, and I would tell a dude, know what you're getting into. That's the most I'm gonna say.
Fucking for love. I think it's a difference between slutting and fucking for love. Some girls real life have sex with it because they think that nigga really likes you.
No, that's not really fucking for lust. Because bitch, if you got to give your pants up every time you meet a new dude, they ain't gonna watch you. That's lust.
Right.
I mean, you walk past somebody and it's like a wet paper towel. You know, when you get a wet paper towel, you throw away, get another one.
Yeah.
Come on, man. If every time you open your legs, your pants get moist, and he done been with 20 other girls in the CCC. He don't want you. He trying to make a record.
He want to make a record.
No, screenshot that.
Screenshot.
Are y'all screenshotters? I know most girls are.
I am. Right.
Are you a fan of the screenshots?
I am not.
So are you all women screenshotters?
If I screenshot something, it's when we're in a group and I said something to somebody and they say they didn't see it, then I screenshot and say, but bitch, you liked it. Reading is fundamental.
Right. But you
that's the like most it. Screenshot I'm going to do is going to be in the group to let them know, this is what you said on this date. That's it. I don't believe
it. Amnesia.
Yeah.
I got a lot of that.
Turn up quick for what just happened? Oh, no.
Don Wilson asks, when y'all next event?
Our anniversary.
June
16th. We had a red light party for all the hoes. They gotta have, you know, the green is available, yellow is I'm willing, and the red is no stop playing with me. I ain't trying to give you that.
I did see that. Hey, that's I always look forward to the skating ring when that's my.
Well, we not doing crystals this year. We doing Anacostia Park.
I'm with that.
I'm too tall to be getting some skates and fall.
No, you're not. It's okay.
With the educated question. What are some of the foundations that Stiletto Drive is on?
What foundations that you stand on?
I'm sorry.
Okay, so we do Jiraiya's Place. We've been doing that since our existence. That's is a foundation that's for troubled teen women. So we've given to them every year. We've done car washes, fish fries, where they've gotten all the proceeds. We're not a club to be like, oh, we're doing this for this, and then we keep a portion of the proceeds. When we say we're doing it for this purpose, that's for that purpose. We're not a club that tries to do things just to say we did it. So, like, when we do our book bag drive, we do Maryland, D.C., and Virginia. People may not realize it, but we ask for donations, but we give those book bags to any kids. We don't say, oh, come and bring your income requirements. If you say your kid need it, we're going to give it to you.
Who the hell is doing that?
We do.
I mean,
I'm talking about asking for somebody. I've seen clubs say,
don't come if your kid don't need an ID. I've seen clubs when you go places.
If you don't live in D.C. and you in Maryland.
Yeah, or they'll just be like, bring something to show this your kid, you know, so many kids per household. I just ask that you register the kids and don't be the adult to come and say, I got 10 kids at home. Nah, but bring me all the kids so I can hand it to them.
Right.
But we don't have we do the breakfast with Santa every year, and we do that in two cities.
And Halloween too.
And we do Halloween. We do the trunk or treat every day. Yeah. Y'all did trunk or treat with us before. Mm-hmm.
Did trunk or treat twice with y'all.
Yeah, we do. I mean, we do so much in giving back to the community, as far as to try to make sure things. Every year we do the autism walk, and people may not realize it, but Stiletto Drivers does the autism walk. We've done the lupus walk because I personally have lupus, so my sister support me, and we come out and walk for that. It's little different walks and races that we've participated. We did the bubble run, and although the bubble run seems like it's fun, it actually supports the Kidney Foundation. So if it's something out there and if people reach out to us, we had a family that told us their house burned down out Baltimore. We went out there and took stuff to them. I was a little disappointed in that family because when we got to the grandmother's house, we found out that was their house. But hey, it is what it is. So
that's what's up, though.
Y'all always big on the community. I'll give you that much. Like, every time we turn around, Stiletto has some kind of either charity or for the kids or something. Y'all not really into the turn-up thing, I see.
I'm like,
turn-up to the max. I can't tell y'all every single event I've ever been to, I've never seen her not at an event. Mm-hmm. You get out so much. Do you work, Mo? Like, is you part of your little team? You don't sleep.
I do sleep. When? I sleep well at night.
Yes, she do.
Oh, I sleep.
In the daytime, too.
I sleep.
Mm-hmm. Oh, she got one of them jobs.
No.
Kickback.
No. Inferno has her 8 to 5, 9 to 5. But at the end of the day, you make time for what you want to make time for. And what I'm not going to do is let these four walls cave in on me. Live your life. So you're sitting in the house, That's certain people, but growing up, my brother and sister could tell you, I was that sister that was always out. So I'm used to it. I run with you. I ain't mad. I'm ready. We can go. I mean, that's just me. Anybody knows me know my personality is to go. I'll sit down when I'm tired. Believe me, I will. But at the end of the day, I enjoy my life. I enjoy what I do and how I do it. And that's that. They are always aware of where I am. When I be like, Ferno at the God darn it. That's just me. So to tell me I can't go, it'd be like, why can't I do what? Like, it would just be like, no, we just leave Ferno alone. Ferno be your own little world. So I mean, it's just, that's just what I do. I mean, I don't bother nobody. At least I hope I don't. And if I do, please bring it to my attention because I'll definitely address it. But hopefully everything is good. That's what I do though, right?
You're not wrong with them.
But that's what I do. Like, I enjoy my life. And when I go meet with God, I want to be able to say, you had a good time in your life versus what did you do? What did you accomplish? No, you can work all day long, but what do you do to enjoy yourself out of a car club, out of a bike club? I have a lot of stuff that I can do. I mean, you know, but it's like, I enjoy what I do. So that's just it. So everybody can say I'm turned. I'm not turned. This is just me. I ain't had nothing to drink today, boy, but it's coming. That's a good one. Free spirit, that's who I am. That's just who I am. I'm just happy.
Rose said, what club y'all want to do an event with that you haven't already done one with?
We don't solicit to do events. If they come and ask us to do something with us, we will. And when we do,
collaborate,
when we do community events, we say whoever wants to join. So we're not singling anyone out or excluding anyone. But if you're going to come do something with us, we just ask that you come professional and ready to do it because, again, my mouth will let you know you don't know what you need to do.
Inferno can't save you.
I know you heard that.
I just walked the other direction. Okay, cool.
Jeep Tutra say, what's Stiletto's biggest accomplishments over the years?
The biggest accomplishment, we got seen on Fox 5 as well as on NBC during our book bag drive. They recognized us. And I'm going to say for us, when we've done two things, when they had the water crisis out Michigan, we sent 2 tractor trailers full of water to Michigan.
And they still need water. Still, yeah.
They still need water?
Yes.
They need a new system out there. So
about to get shit with Trump in it now. Y'all short.
So the 2 tractor trailers full of water out there. And then when New Jersey had that issue, we sent $2,000 out there.
That's what's up. So, you know, Stiletto, they give back always.
Is this Shaq?
Not even to the DMV, right? Nationwide.
I think we already covered this. Shaq says, how does Stiletto drivers feel about the CCC community as a whole? What steps can y'all take to bring the community together?
That was earlier, but we can go back.
Dream Girl's here now, so we like to have
her. That's because you know I answered that question.
You saying she's about to come with something fierce and highly educated. Everybody,
first of all, people need to understand their place and stay in your place in the club. Don't worry about what the next club doing. If you stop worrying about what the next club doing, or if you have a problem with somebody, instead of taking it to social media, instead of trying to take it to another club and address your issues or your beef with that club, take it to the person. Because honestly, you don't have a beef with the whole club. You have a beef with a person. But if you offended that person in front of their club and they took up with them, you can't get mad. That's like if someone does something to one of these girls, my mouth is going to come. But I'm going to also pull you to the side and say, if you have a problem with her, we can stand right here and you can talk to that person. Stop trying to fight about everything, because at the end of the day, you fight, you get your ass whooped, then you're going to come back and want to fight again, or you want to pull a weapon. So be above all that. Go to that person, explain to them what it is that they, like they say in the Bible, if you go to your transgressor, so if they did a transgression against you, go to that person, discuss it with them. And if you don't, I mean, I'm not one that's going to say no new clubs, because everybody has their fit. So you can't get mad at the club you're in and say, I'm going to start a club. No, what you do is find out what it is about that club that doesn't fit you. Because sometimes you start up these clubs and then your club end up closing. I mean, there's some people out here that's been in 6-7 clubs.
Yeah.
Also, as a club yourself, stop taking everybody. Actually have a true prospect period. Don't start a club and everybody in the club got a damn title. how the hell you been in the club for 6 months, but now you the president? You just got here. That club been out for 2 years. You the president? Nah, boo. That's because everybody else in the club done quit or left. Actually have some values about yourself. It's not for me to tell you what your values should be, but have some values about yourself. And then you have, and go to the other leaders here. It's not, oh, you can't tell me what to do. No, instead of you can't tell me what to do, can you educate me and show me how to sustain as long as you all have? I mean, people can say stuff about clubs all day, but we've been here 7 years. We started out with 3 members. We had 15. We got up to 20 and we down to 15. Some people left because of financial reasons. Some people left because they couldn't handle, you know, things, but we still sustain. So don't take it as, oh, they think they're cute. Take it as maybe use them as an example of things we should aspire to. And stop trying to have a beef with everybody. So what, somebody started another Camaro club? Maybe they couldn't find a club that they actually was a fit. And truth of the matter is, you may not want that person in your club, so let them go ahead and do their thing. But when they come out, show them how to come out the right way by embracing them and taking, you know, saying, hey, you know, y'all starting up, make sure you got this, this, and this in order. You know, when you come out, don't come out stepping on people's toes. It's clubs that just started this year. You already stepping on people's toes. It's people got events and you don't care that they have an event. I'm one, if it's another club that got an event, I don't care if it's 20 of us. How about let's just try to have some actual unity in the community? You see this club has an event on this day. Before you even post your flyer, I see you have something on this day. We wanted to do something. Would you mind if we do it in the morning and y'all do y'all's in the evening? But don't try to make it with your event going to the end, to the beginning of their event. So then people tired after they left your event that they've been there from 2 to 12. You know, if you about unity, then be about that. Unify with the community and stop trying to have so much separation. And I feel like that's with not just car clubs, but bike clubs and social clubs. Because we all out in the same community. We all live here. We all share the streets.
Yeah, that's true. So how you feel about like one of your members going to another club? You still show them, you know, love, speak?
We got members in other clubs.
Okay.
So one of our members went to y'all club.
Who?
Miss Bossy.
Bossy.
She was our member.
Bossy was with y'all.
She was. Hey,
ain't see on it. Hey, Bossy, we never knew that. I thought she came from what she called him, swerving on him.
She went from swerving. We made her wait 4 or 5 months before we would even let her prospect. Then she came to us. After we talked to Jimmy about it, we did the proper thing and talked to him and let him know. Just because we talk to you don't mean we not going to take them, but we're going to show you enough respect to let you know that, you know, we had China that was with us. She went to HH, but that one was kind of okay because she was still in the prospect period. You got Cherokee that's now in QK. You know, we have people that they might not have fisted let them drive us.
Cordy said that's Ho Gotti.
I
got you, guys. I got you. That's some whole Gotti shit.
We're not going to say bad things about former members. They still our sisters, whether they get down or they play down. We don't talk bad about our former members because she's still our sister.
Would you allow, like, I mean, we say it every time, but like, not another club, but like, you know, now there's the, I don't even know how to classify them.
Just say it.
Like the are the entertainment, because they said it like ENT, like Beltway and DOP, like, are y'all cool with if one of your members wanted to do an outside organization outside of Stiletto?
What you mean outside organization?
Well, like if they wanted to join one of those, you know,
like what? I'm gonna let Nene answer that.
The other social groups.
Go ahead, Nina.
No,
you used to be there or something. Oh. You tried it. Didn't really like
something
it?
Like that. But
who you try to go to?
No, I mean, it wasn't anything out. It was just something that was even a club, but it was something called the GGG, Good Girl, you know, thingy. And it didn't turn out so well. So that's not allowed
What's a GGG? I'm lost.
Yeah. It was a good girlfriend. Good girlfriends. Just the group of girls getting together, hanging out sometimes.
It was some Lesbo shit right there. Hell yeah.
It was a spinoff. I'm going to go with my founder's words. It was a spinoff social club. That wasn't labeled as a social club. It was just the good girlfriends group. So why you need a name for something? Why you need a title if you're just hanging out with your girlfriends?
But yeah, it's not accepted.
So
you will get put out.
So like those ones that we mentioned, y'all wouldn't be cool with that.
What, joining? Hanging?
Yeah, like if they...
Hang out with them.
Well, I'm hanging with them all day.
We can hang out with them. That's not
but classified. But you wouldn't allow a member to go over there and hang.
I ain't finna stand that on my car,
no.
Do y'all feel like that's wrong for you to like...
If you put it on your car, yes, we would take it off.
Yes.
You take that off or you take your little off.
You got to choose.
So from one president to another president, right? Do you feel as a president of a club, is that acceptable?
Hell no. If you're in Stiletto Drivers, you are a Stiletto Driver. The only other logo that was allowed to be on anybody's car was the DMV Races, because that's not a club. That's a racing group.
So would it be the same thing? Every Stiletto Driver DMV and Polis, like the same thing?
No, because that's a club. They classify themselves as a... Actually, didn't they say they was a social club? At one point?
I don't know. I've heard a lot.
At one point, it was, we're not a car club, we're a social club, we're not this, we're not that. But if you classify yourself as something more, DMV Races wasn't considered to be a club. It was considered to be a movement. And that's like having We Are One or something. That's different.
Beltway Bully said that they're a race team.
Yeah.
They race. And DOP is a entertainment. They turn up like... They throw parties. That's what they do. Mm-hmm. So would you be cool with your people?
That's what they do.
Want to be a race team?
That's what they do.
That's what they do. We don't have to do what they do.
Well, that's not what we're saying. We said we'd be cool
with you.
If one of your people wanted to go be Beltway Bully's race team and race with them, and would it be cool if they put them Beltway on
the
car?
They need to bring it before the board and let the board vote on it.
So that would be something that we have for grabs, Tosha.
I doubt if it pays. They
Tasha said DMV and Pollard is not a club. Emphasis on the word not.
Okay, I'm not saying they are.
Oh, sure. No. Liv says DOP is a club now. They have logos.
See?
Okay, to each his own.
Exactly.
That's not an SD issue. It's not an SD problem.
Because our girls know you don't put nobody's logo on your car without talking
about it. We can't do that with that.
Yeah, hey, DMV and Pollard, we're going to get y'all on here, man. We're going to have to set it up to get y'all on here, man. Because they like... They hear DMV and Polly. What? Hell
no. I think I've made a flyer for them before, and I'm pretty sure that person who asked me to make the flyer told me that they was a club.
BWB. Zoe, what the fuck are you talking about? What's BWB? Oh, you know?
No, I don't. Everything coming from Zoe, you never know.
Say BWB is the new DMV race car. Oh, okay. Race cars. I remember them. Somewhat. What?
Okay.
I'm scratching my head.
What's wrong with him?
Too many damn abbreviations and shit. I need to just write shit out.
BWB is a race what?
BWB is the new DMV race cars. Remember when they spelled race cars like R-A-C-A-H-S?
Racist.
Like,
race.
I thought he was trying to.
I thought it was ratchet.
Ratchet.
Your founder. Ratchet club. And I ain't gonna call them ratchet.
Oh, he said, but they're slower.
Wouldn't they?
That can't be part of the
system.
We can't do nothing with that.
Exactly.
Damn,
well.
That's not an SD issue either.
SD don't seem like I already got no goddamn issues.
They go in that room and scream at each other.
Hell yeah. That's dangerous. Stab each other.
You can put a fierce owl one in them motherfuckers.
All your club, you know, whatever goes on, like as Dream Girl said, with your club, don't need to be exposed. We could go outside. We probably could powwow 10 minutes ago. You would never know. And that's what these other clubs have to do. Powwow with your club. Like Dream Girl said, don't go on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. I don't know. Fernal's still trying to get her Snapchat working. But don't go on all that stuff and expose your club. Because the only person that goes on to your club should be your club. So no matter what, when we move, we're moving in happiness. We're moving in, hey, we got to get through this. And we could just argue 10 minutes ago. You're not going to see that. So if you're looking for an issue from SD, unfortunately, we don't have that available at this moment. Sorry.
No, that's a good thing. That's a good thing.
We just don't have that.
Too many of us.
Why we keep talking about the bullies? Let them live. Because you're in the fucking CC. So if you in here, then...
Who talked about it? We were over like, there 20 minutes ago.
It was. But, I mean, you're part of the conversation. You in the CC. You a part of the CC. You relevant. Like... I didn't make y'all come out and become. We had Beltway Bullies on the show, so I mean, questions people want to know.
Hey, Dream Girl, this is the second time Zoe talking about some fried chicken, man. I know about some fried chicken, man.
Zoe, I don't eat chicken no more, so I'll fry you some fish though.
In the chat, what's in the chat? I don't know what's in the chat. I don't know what you're talking about either. So yeah.
In the word.
Yeah. No, we're just reading out the comments.
Yeah, we're reading the comments. I'm just upset that we brought up Beltway Bullies again, but I mean,
let's not even talk about it anymore.
We're
going to
go
past
that comment.
Okay.
You know, that was earlier. Okay. These niggas is promoting fried chicken and Pops Cups to the everybody needs fried chicken and Pops Cups.
I got you.
Some
waiting for more chicken. Can we get some of this damn chicken?
That's what I'm saying.
I feel like you should have came to the show with the chicken. I came
from work, so I'm sorry. But I actually did bring y'all some ice cream, but I couldn't find a refrigerator, so I left it in the car.
Oh, that's all good.
Ice cream in the car, after party at Dream Girl House. She's going to cook.
Dream Girl live far away.
You going to Virginia?
Exactly.
We're going to carpool.
By being female, you know, you don't see typical females like it's a car. So what like gave y'all the motivation or gave each one of y'all, I mean, probably self-motivational to join up in the AC?
Honey started it. Honey had the vision. Honey doesn't have any sisters. So Honey wanted cute girls. They like cars like she do. And the way that she started recruiting was me and Honey have known each other since 7th grade. So first she started with people who she knew all her life. Was like, come on. And I remember telling her, I only got this charger. I ain't really trying to do that. She was like, come on. Plus, I need somebody who could talk to people because you talk more than I do. Really? I said, you know people don't like how I talk. And then as it happened, people started joining in. We met Inferno one night.
Turned up.
It was our girl Kelly. This passed away. Rest in peace, Kelly. It was her birthday. It was a month after I had a stroke, so it was my first time out. Inferno was dancing with me. I was like, "You want to join our club?" And she was like, "Let me. What do you guys do?" And she started. So she joined up. Nina hit us on the inbox because she already was around the CCC, and she was like, "Hey, you know." Same thing with this one right here. And then they bought the best friend.
We actually are some real sisters, though. Yeah. We are like real sisters.
That's what's up.
Yeah, everybody has a connection somewhere in the club. There's a connection. So
do you have to have a connection to join?
No, but you got to have a connection to stay. Because there's been members who they didn't quite understand it, where it was time to vote, and people was like, I'm not going to vote her in. I'm not going to vote her in. And then I'm like, all right, well, let's just tell her we're going to extend her probation period so we can give her the opportunity. Because they are members who, you know. And then we have some members who, unfortunately, they bought around a certain element. And we had to tell them, hey, you will have to choose. And they chose.
Is it like rules y'all got? Like, you can't be ratchet when you go out? Or no doing? Yeah, because y'all ladies, it's different. Like, dude, you just do whatever you want. Throw caution to the wind, my nigga. Get out there and do whatever you want to do. But ladies, look, y'all got to carry yourself a certain way. Like, is there a code of ethics that y'all live by? Like,
you give me a couple of shots away, because I might get a little ratchet on you. Apparently, I swallowed a hot dog one time.
Oh, glizzy lovers.
I don't remember that.
I think the most important part of that, while we're out, we still try to be respectable.
Yeah.
Right.
We still, you know, even for myself, anybody know me, know Fern are going to have her a drink. That's a given. I'm going to have me two.
Or three.
Or three. Okay, that's even better.
Probably. So when I'm alcoholic now?
No. But if Inferno gets too many, one of us is going to pull it to the side and say, come on. We're not even going to leave it there. We're going to all leave as a group.
I was like, y'all ain't allowed to leave.
But I'm always aware, but whatever we're doing, you know, everybody has their different level.
Mm-hmm.
So at the end of the day, I'm still going to be respectable in what I'm doing.
Right.
It won't be no real money. Get off of me. No, that's too far. So it's not like we're going to be out there exposing ourselves. No, baby. You got to sit down somewhere. So it's just different levels to it. But we're not that take your shirt off, stand in the middle of the street, shake it.
Oh, hell yeah.
We had one or two that tried it, though.
Right now.
I can pull out some pictures or something.
We don't want no pictures.
They sell all the potty tickets, though. I feel like it's necessary to have, like, one ratchet-ass joint.
We don't have to have no ratchet. Didn't you just hear them ask for my fried chicken?
Yeah, you
tried. As
anybody, any party SD had that I haven't cooked, except for the skate party. Anything we do, we just cook. Cook and sell juice.
Good house.
The juice is kind of good, though, man. I remember having one last year.
We need a ratchet.
No, we ain't ratchet.
Yeah, just one.
If we have one ratchet person, they'll think the whole club is ratchet. And I'm not with that.
No, but y'all already set y'all foundation, though. They already know y'all don't rock like that. So.
I'm guilty by association in that form.
But I'll be quick to correct that.
Yes,
I'm like the mom of the group. If I feel like Inferno drink too much, I'm like, Inferno, give in. Or I feel like Dream Girl dancing too hard, you drank too hard. Come on, too much.
So we watch each other. There's no ifs or buts about that, no matter what. And that's what clubs are about. You should be able to, especially, you know, you're not going to see SD doing a burnout. First of all, unless you buy my tires.
Not true.
Not me.
You won't see her do it, but Honey and myself
do it. They will do it.
I would love to see Honey do a goddamn.
Honey will do a burnout and then leave your ass with some smoke. Yes, and then will. Tell you come on race after she finish.
Yes, I need to meet this Honey. Every time I see Honey, this is all I get. She's sitting in the chair with sunglasses on. Hey, baby. And then she gone. You know what I see her. That much. She's elusive. Like.
What I mean by burnout, like just driving down the street. I'm not saying, you know.
We're not reckless.
Y'all not like parking lot burnouts and all that stupid shit. Look at you. She's like, yeah, I'm kind of famous.
Not Penn State.
We're not going to do it where it brings attention to us.
Right. You know what? I don't see. That's the one place I think I've never ran into y'all was like at Penn. Y'all like anti-Penn.
We go to Applebee's.
We hit local neighborhood Applebee's.
Y'all wild, man.
Say too much shit going up here.
Too much up here.
We're not going to put each other in harm's way. And unfortunately, it's been too much harm in the way at Penn. So
God damn.
I don't want y'all there.
Motherfucking Penn. I think it's acting like, oh, I took y'all around 4. Chesapeake,
you watch yourself. But wait a minute, we cool at Chesapeake because we got people that live over there.
Don't both be over there.
Don't come.
Exactly. I ain't never had no problems over there.
Females never do. Y'all like the only people that go in the most fucked up neighborhoods ever. Who lived in a ghetto neighborhood back in the day? Try to call the dude, tell him to come pick you up and shit.
I did.
You know that brother Waller living out there?
Can you meet me at Minnesota Avenue, please?
I was told, can you meet me down at Capitol Heights Metro Station? I am not coming up there. No, my godmother lived on 58. Oh, right. Yeah. The house right there next to where the project's in. She lived right there.
So
like
a dude's up, they ain't gonna do nothing. Come
on. I know my cousin. Okay. Man, anybody trying to hear all that?
I ain't like a bitch. I grew up in Sugar Grove, so I knew.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, I was Drum Avenue, emo.
Y'all know I love it. So. I wasn't. Come on up here, baby. Everybody go bother you.
Y'all done got a rag of niggas jumped out just right. Robbing everything. Fuck with y'all. Look at Nene try to be quiet. Like,
no.
I ain't got a couple niggas that Ace ain't gonna say nothing to me.
No, Ace ain't saying anything, baby.
Let me tell you, because I don't play that with him and he don't play that with me. So,
baby. You, baby.
Y'all wild, man. But we almost close to the end. Y'all want to drop, like, if somebody want to get in contact with SD, like, how do they get y'all?
You can hit up this Stiletto Drivers fan page on Facebook or on Instagram and just send a DM. Somebody will respond to you. Make sure that you have all your ducks in a row when you hit it. We're going to need your government name, not what you want your club name to be. And if your club name sounds like a pole name, we definitely not going to let you keep it.
Sexual listen.
Don't come talking about you tasty, looking like you just...
You're black.
You're bland.
Wow.
Because you got to season that chicken just right there.
I mean, just come correct. Don't come and think, oh, just because you sign up or you prospect, you have a voice. Because I'm going to be honest with you. I'm the first one to tell you prospects don't have no damn voice. You don't. It's unfortunate, but only way you're going to learn to get respect in your club and respect your board and the people that have titles is to understand that you don't. So when you're a prospect, you are there to prove yourself, mm-hmm. not to try to take over the club because you'll get told it's not happening.
I know you heard that. But you said y'all page, you want to put that out there, what that is?
Is Stiletto Drivers on Facebook is... I think it's under Stiletto Drivers. I think we just changed it to Stiletto Drivers.
/social club.
Yeah, it says that. And then it's Stiletto Drivers. It actually is just Stiletto Drivers on Instagram. Or you can hit any member of the club and they'll forward it to the right person.
Boom. Anybody want to drop their personal?
Personal IGs, personal.
I know my Instagram. I know my Instagram.
Everybody on IG anyway.
All you got to do is do a search for SD. Put SD in the search and
everybody
a Stiletto Driver.
Yeah.
Somebody
will pop up.
You can Google them. That's how they pop up.
You could do a search for the pound for the hashtag pound SD for life and it'll pop up.
Boom.
Hashtag SD to that pound.
Bam. I am one of the older members of the club. So that
number
is
number
the
sign.
Number sign.
Number sign.
Pound. Pound it. I'm about to bring that back. Everything. Pound it. That's what's up. All right, man. So that's another episode of Fools and Doors, man. We want to thank Stiletto Drives for coming out in the building, man, and messing with us. And we're going to get with y'all next week. We out here.
Hey. All right.